At the center of Phoebe Waller-Bridge's Fleabag is an unexpected love story. Not that one. Across the two seasons, we see the relationship between Fleabag and Claire evolve as they overcome the most challenging circumstances to accept, support, and love each other despite their differences. The Swaddle presents Recasting. Sisterhood, or the relationship between sisters, has been explored in all kinds of pop culture, but rarely have we seen a portrayal as nuanced and raw as this one.
I just have a feeling.
I would have come up with my own joke if you hadn't put that one in my head.
To begin with, it establishes the conflicting nature of the bond between two sisters. A sibling can be someone who you reminisce about childhood memories with, who understands and shares your family trauma, and who makes for the only bearable company during countless family get-togethers. At the same time, because you've grown up together, they are also the ones who know and even weaponize the most embarrassing things about you, cross personal boundaries with entitlement, and most importantly, find it difficult to accept your ability to evolve into a different person.
Why are there so many people here?
Well, it's just successful, I guess.
The main conflict between Fleabag and Claire also arises from this contradiction of sisters being the people you might be closest to, but also the ones who can hit you where it really hurts.
Just thought we were hanging out. Just as friends.
We're not friends. We are sisters. Get your own friends.
Claire's husband Martin kisses Fleabag one night at Claire's birthday party. When Fleabag first tells Claire, Claire finds it difficult to process, but chooses to believe her sister, and later, even promises to leave Martin. But by the end of season one, Claire decides to stay with her husband and seems to believe his version of the story, that the promiscuous Fleabag tried to seduce Martin, just as she had previously seduced her best friend's boyfriend.
You have to believe me.
How can I believe you?
Because I'm your sister.
After what you did to Boo.
At one level, the issue is about sibling loyalty and Claire having to choose her husband over her sister. Not necessarily because she loves her sister less or doesn't see her side of things, but because she's in denial about who her husband is and wants to badly save a marriage she has put so many years of work into. At the same time, the way they deal with the Martin problem initially also seems to be a culmination of an issue the two sisters have had since the time we're first introduced to them together on screen.
I'm wearing the top that she lost years ago.
And it's a pattern that plays out repeatedly with tops, coats, and even vibrators.
Stop stealing my things. I'm just checking it's working.
Claire gets extremely possessive as Fleabag nonchalantly steals her things. However, as the story evolves, in season two, we see an entirely new dimension to the problem.
He kissed me!
Oh, I know!
You know? Then why have we been spending
this time? Because you're fine! You'll always be fine. You'll always be interesting with your quirky cafe and your dead best friend. You just make me feel like I failed.
Claire breaks down and indicates that she knows the truth, but prefers being in denial because it means that her husband is attracted to Fleabag, who will always be the interesting one. This scene becomes an open acknowledgement of an important aspect of their dynamic as sisters, competition. It's not even necessarily negative, but it arises from an almost natural tendency for sisters to compare and compete. And it is as much about how they view each other.
Sister's got whoppers, but she got all her mum's good bits.
As it is about how others view them. But Claire acknowledging this out loud doesn't lead to a resolution of this issue. Instead, there is an acceptance of this being a part of their equation as sisters, and a recognition of their mutual care and affection overpowering this instinct. As sisters, they have been able to care for each other in situations where they might have been too embarrassed or too proud to ask anyone else for help, be it Claire bailing out her sister with money or Fleabag covering up for Claire's miscarriage. In some cases, the level of familiarity they share might become difficult, but in most situations, their mutual awareness of each other's needs and behavior patterns also enables them to push each other to do what will make them happy. This becomes especially apparent in the culmination of the series, as Claire helps the hot priest and Fleabag get together, while Fleabag encourages Claire to chase after the man she loves. In the penultimate scene of the series finale, Claire and Fleabag even end up declaring how much they mean to each other.
The only person I'd run for an airport for is you.
And just like that,
this is a love story.